Now at this time, let's select three different fluorophores and three PMTs, and we'll look at our separate images. So I'm gonna click on the Leica settings, and I'm gonna go to Fitzy Tritzy CY5. This is now three fluorophores that we're going to be exciting based on three laser lines. I'm gonna turn off the UV laser line since we don't need that. But you see a 488 laser line, you see a 543 laser line, and you see a 633 laser line, all illuminated on our spectrum. You also see the various emission curves as a result of the excitation based on these laser lines. And concurrently, we have a photomultiplier tube set below this graph of where the emission is going to take place. So this photomultiplier tube is collecting here, this PMT is collecting here, and this PMT is collecting here. We're going to be outputting our image in three colors, green, red, and blue, but we can also modify these colors as you'll see in a second. Also, please note that all three photomultiplier tubes are now activated. So I'm going to click on live, and if you look on the right screen, you'll now see an image with four windows in it. The first one is the Fitzy, the second one is the Tritzy, and this is the CY5. Again, we want to set our smart gain and offset for each of these windows. So we'll click on the first one. If you double click, only that one comes up. And now we can increase our smart gain. Again, we want to be around 900, maybe 950, certainly below 1,000. So we're at 978 on our smart gain. Let's check our offset. Our offset should be minus about 0.3, 0.4. Remember, we can always use the lookup table to show us our green and blue pixels. So if we lower the smart gain, make some of our blue pixels go away. So we have few blue pixels, and use our smart offset until the green pixels just go away. Now we have a perfectly set image. We'll click through our lookup table, and now our Fitzy is set perfectly. If we double click again on the Fitzy window, the other windows come up again. Let's double click on the Tritzy window. And now we'll set our smart gain and our offset. We'll go to lookup table first. Too many blue pixels, so we'll lower our gain until our blue pixels start to go away. And we'll control our offset until our green pixels appear and then go away. So right about there. So we'll double click again on the lookup table. Now our Tritzy looks very nice. We'll double click on that window, and now we're in the CY5 window. Again, we'll click on the lookup table. We'll get rid of our blue pixels. You can see that there's a lot of blue pixels there. So we'll minimize those and now control our offset. That looks pretty good. Double click on that window. And now we'll click through the lookup table and we see the composite image showing all of this information output into one different image. We have three distinct colors here. We have a blue color, a pink color, and then a golden color, actually a fourth color, sort of a brownish color. So we're really getting a lot of information back by engaging all of these PMTs. Also, don't forget that your focus is very important. You could be under-focused or over-focused, and that will dramatically impact the quality of your image. As you can see, I'm focusing through back and forth, and you can see how the focus can actually eliminate the illumination altogether. So make sure that you're highly focused on your specimen. One easy way to do this is to use a transmitted light PMT. So we'll double click on the composite image. We're going to go over here and click on stop. Let's deactivate all three of the photomultiplier tubes, and we'll turn on only the bright field photomultiplier tube for transmitted light. Now if I click on live, here is my image in bright field. Again, I can use my lookup table to look at blue pixels. Minimize those, and green pixels. get a few green pixels, and now double click through my lookup table, and now I have a decent transmitted light image. But notice how it changes dramatically when I focus back and forth through the specimen. Transmitted light is returning more information to you about the specimen than the fluorophores are. So your focus is very critical, both on transmitted light and in fluorescence. There is also the possibility that I may want to use all four PMTs simultaneously. I might have three different fluorophores that I'm looking at, and I also want to use the transmitted light PMT, which we already used. So let's turn them all on and look at our image. So I'm going to activate the PMTs. All four are now activated, including the transmitted light PMT. We'll click on live. And now if you look at the right screen, you see all four of our PMTs illuminated together with our composite image. Now, why is this important? Sometimes there are structures that can only be seen in transmitted light. For example, that nucleus there, there's a nucleus down here inside of this cell. There's also other cellular material in here that you can see that is not illuminated by any of the fluorophores. For example, if you look at the FITC, you see no nucleus here. You see some of this intracellular material here, but you don't see that nucleus, which is a region of interest. What about the TRITC? Same thing, no nucleus. What about the CY5? Once again, no nucleus. But if I go to the transmitted light PMT, voila, there's my nucleus. So sometimes there are structures that you need to see present in your specimen that will not be illuminated by a fluorophore, and so it's important sometimes to use all four PMTs, then you get a true picture of everything that's going on in your specimen. Now for the end of this chapter, we have more images from Rigoberto Ramirez and Ernie Kwok. This is one of the guard cells of Arabidopsis thaliana. The endoplasmic reticulum is labeled with yellow fluorescent protein. It shows that the endoplasmic reticulum is localized around the nuclei. Here is one of the leaf cells of Arabidopsis. The endoplasmic reticulum is again labeled with yellow fluorescent protein. The chloroplasts are labeled with cyan fluorescent protein. It shows how the endoplasmic reticulum forms baskets around the chloroplasts near the cell membrane. Here's an image of tobacco cells. Plastids are labeled with green fluorescent protein, or GFP, and the nuclear DNA is labeled with DAPI. The plastids are shown surrounding the nucleus. Finally, here is a video showing the three-dimensional arrangement of the plastids. They engulf the nucleus during interphase.